I was told I'm not currently a good candidate for hair transplant. When will I be a suitable candidate? I consulted a hair transplant surgeon and was told I'm not a candidate. I have gaps of thinning hair rather than bald spots, and the incisions would risk damaging the existing follicles. I'm currently taking finasteride for 2 months now. When will I be a suitable candidate for the procedure? Is it possible to transplant hair to the thinning areas? Should I consult another surgeon? I do not have any hair loss at the temples or front.
Thank you for your question. You submitted a photo, and in your question, you state that you had gone for a consultation and you were advised that you are not a good hair transplant candidate. You're on finasteride for a couple of months and you want to get some guidance. Well, I'm actually very pleased to know that someone who you saw decided that you weren't a good candidate for transplantation. And it requires a little bit of understanding as to why you're not a good candidate. First, let's understand what is a hair transplant. A hair transplant is the strategic movement or literal transplantation of hairs from an area in the back of the scalp that we refer to as the genetically resistant area or the donor area. Now, this is a narrow space. And it is limited. When you look at a male who has the very advanced hair loss, where they just have the horseshoe kind of pattern, that hair is permanent. It's not going to fall out. And the scientific idea is that since it's permanent, that those hairs can be cut out and then placed in another area strategically. Now, when we look at the space on the back of the scalp, and this area we refer to as the crown, the surface area of the crown is fairly large. And it is very common for men to come in and say, "I want to cover the bald spot." But the problem is the amount of area to cover requires a large number of grafts. And unfortunately, the donor area is fairly limited. The next reason that you need to also understand is your hair is thinning, but you may not have bald areas, which means that if you were to look at your scalp with a microscope, there's a good chance that there's a lot of existing hair and that it would be not to your benefit to then place grafts and literally destroy those viable hair follicles. I think that the strategy that your doctor may have suggested was the finasteride to see if the finasteride can reverse the hair thinning. Let's just understand finasteride for a moment. Finasteride is a drug that is taken once a day. It's 1 milligram, and it is used to inhibit an enzyme called 5-alpha reductase. 5-alpha reductase converts testosterone to dihydrotestosterone. Now, this dihydrotestosterone can cause susceptible hair follicles to thin and to eventually disappear. So many men, particularly men with crown hair loss, will respond to finasteride. So I think you're on the right track. At this time, unfortunately, a lot of men don't want to take finasteride, especially in their 20s and 30s, because when they're doing research, they're seeing concerns about long-term sexual side effects. In fact, so many people come to us for one of our unique treatments that we call hair regeneration, I'll discuss in a moment, because they don't want to take finasteride and they're having progressive hair loss. The understanding now that might help you is a concept that we've been in a leadership position with, and this is the method that we call hair regeneration. It was discovered several years ago after the introduction of a material called extracellular matrix, and this type derived from pig bladder, that helps wound healing using adult stem cells, which means your own body's stem cells, to heal by duplication of tissue that is native to a given area where the extracellular matrix is applied. So when it's applied to muscle, you are able to regenerate muscle. When you apply it to skin, you regenerate skin. Well, although hair is an organ and you can't regenerate or duplicate hairs or clone hairs, which has been the holy grail of hair restoration, we can restore the cells and signals necessary for hair growth. Now, this is something that we have developed a formulation, a method, a delivery system. And we do these injections several times a week for people who come to us from all over the world. And this might be an option that you can investigate. What is unique is that it's a one-time treatment. And once you have this treatment, the hair that is thinning will come back thicker. Now, the results can take anywhere from a few months to up to 18 months. We used to say about a year, but we have learned over time that there are a category of people that we call slow growers. And they take a little bit longer, but we have seen tremendous benefit over the course of 18 months. With male pattern hair loss, we're approaching 100% success rate, defined by significant improvement that people can see and appreciate with before and after pictures. And we routinely do microscopy. In fact, in our practice, we follow these patients very closely. We follow them at 1 month, 3 months, and at intervals of 3 months all the way up to 18 months. So hair regeneration is something you probably have not heard of in the storm and mess of hair loss solutions that are offered on the web, many of which are completely fake, where people are offering supplements and lights and gimmicks. It is actually very hard to find this particular treatment, but now that you've learned about it, you can investigate this method as an option for you and find a provider who can perform this for you. So I think that you're on the right track and you are fortunate to meet a doctor who wasn't ready to do a hair transplant. And I think that the trial of finasteride is worth considering. See how you do with it and learn more about hair regeneration as also an option to help you stop your hair loss and restore hairs that may or may not be responding to the finasteride. So I know this is new information that you probably haven't heard about, but I hope that you are able to benefit from this. So I wish you the best of luck. I hope that was helpful. And thank you for your question.